In my implementation of namespaces, functions, types, and variables will all be namespaced, but not macros. This is all compatible with typical IntelliSense, and the namespace can be renamed at a single point in a library's header. In the header, we define this namespace macro, which I've given a long name to avoid collisions. Next, we need this group of macros. This n macro can be passed a base name, which it will, through two more macros, prefix with the previously defined namespace. All three of these are preceded by pragma push macro at the start of the file, and followed by pragma pop macro at the end. This keeps these macros defined only between the push and pop, avoiding any collisions, and saves and restores any previous definitions. I recommend when using this namespacing scheme to keep all other macros as internal only since they can't be namespaced. When naming functions, types, and variables, just call the n macro, putting the name of the thing in the brackets. In this example, where the namespace macro is ml underscore, nHello expands to ml underscore hello. In this way, every declaration, definition, and reference to a namespaced thing should be written with the n macro throughout the library files. Because the macros are scoped just within the header code, they need to be defined with the push and pops again in the implementation file. Since the implementation includes the header, the namespace itself is in scope. You could also write the implementation directly inside the header file, but I've showed it this way since it's standard. When using a library namespaced in this way, you can edit the namespace macro in the header to whatever you want, then interact with the library with that namespace prefix. This namespacing method isn't perfect. If you have two source files that were written with the assumption that the namespace was set two different ways, one of them is going to need a find and replace, but it's the best I've worked out in C. Implementing namespaces like this means that, when making a library, you don't need to decide on the balance between a long prefix that avoids collisions and a short prefix which makes for more readable code. Instead, whoever's using your library can make that decision for themselves. I invite you all to critique my code and offer your own implementations of namespaces. Heck, if you think a simple prefix is better, I'm open to your reasons. Cheers!